So we're moving on to examples 3 and 4 in our book. Those are the last examples, but we're going to do a few additional examples. In example 3 and 4, what we do is we solve equations that involve the number e, either as a base of a logarithmic function or as the base of an exponential function. The most important skill in solving those equations is your ability to change either from logarithmic form to exponential form, or from exponential to logarithmic. So let's take a look at the first problem. Natural log of x is equal to 2. My suggestion, a lot of students are confused here, my suggestion to you is rewrite. This is log of x with a base of e is equal to 2. So you've got now a log, a base, an exponent, and a product. And now change to exponential form. So e squared is equal to x. Well, I like to tell you that you have to do a lot more work, but the truth is, you don't. This is in calculation-ready form, and the only thing that you have to do right now is take your graphing calculator and raise e to the power of 2. So there's... If you look at ln, if you look at your calculator, and if you look at ln, you will see in yellow above it e to the x. So if I want to raise e to the second power, first I press second, then I press e to the x, and I just enter 2. I will close the parentheses, though that is unnecessary, and I get my answer 7.389. So x is approximately 7.389. Let's solve the next one. I like to say that everything that you do is different. It is not. This is log of 1 over x with a base of e is equal to 2. Rewrite in exponential form. E squared is equal to 1 over x. Multiply on both sides by x. X e squared is equal to 1. If you're frightened, don't be. Divide by e squared on both sides and get x is equal to 1 over e squared. Take your graphing calculator and do 1 divided by e squared, or you can even do e raised to the power of negative 2. So, taking your calculator, approximating the answer, that's something that's up to you. I've shown you how to use your calculator. We're done with example 3. I left the answer in calculation ready form. Like I said, you approximate it. Let's take a look at example 4. In example 4, now I have e raised to the power of 2x is equal to 9. So what are we going to do? We start with an equation that is an exponential form. So we start with base raised to exponent is equal to product. We're going to change it to another equation that is in logarithmic form. So let's change from exponential to logarithmic. The base is e, the product is 9, and the exponent is 2x. So log of 9 with the base of e is equal to 2x, but log with a base of e is written as natural log. So natural log of 9 is equal to 2x. Right now I could take my calculator and approximate natural log of 9, but I want to have a little bit of fun. And so what I'm going to do, I'm going to multiply both sides by a half. All of this is totally unnecessary, like I said. I'm just practicing my laws and properties. So you have x is equal to 1 half natural log of 9. I'm going to take the 1 half, bring it up. So I'm using the power law. So this is natural log of 9 raised to the 1 half is equal to x. To raise 9 to the power of 1 half is the same as taking the square root of 9. So natural log of 3 is equal to x. Calculation ready form, like I said, you are responsible for finding this using your own calculator. There is an ln key. an extra credit question, there is a second one. So extra credit. What does natural log of 3 mean? And this is supposed to be an element, just in case. So what does natural log of 3 mean? You can write a reply to the video and you can tell me what it is. So that's it. That's example 4.